What's up, guys? Today we're going to read The Radiant Child. It's the story of young artist Jean-Michel Basquiat, and it's actually an award-winning book because of its awesome story and illustrations and message. So let's learn about this artist, Jean-Michel Basquiat. And there's a picture of him there. And then the crown is kind of one of his trademark symbols that he puts in his work. So let's try to look for that in the story. Somewhere in Brooklyn, between hearts that thump double dutch and hopscotch and salty mouths that slurp sweet ice, a little boy dreams of being a famous artist. And Brooklyn is a part of New York City. In his house, you can tell a serious artist dwells here. As he sits at a table with pencils scattered everywhere, Jean-Michel draws from morning till night with a serious face amid a storm of papers. He refuses to sleep until he has created his masterpiece. And he even has on the wall, serious artist at work. What a champ. At night, images enchant Jean-Michel's mind, and he wakes from his dreams to add one more line. His drawings are not neat or clean, nor does he color inside the lines, but they are sloppy, ugly, sometimes weird, but somehow still beautiful drawings. So he uses his lines and shapes and colors and dreams to express himself in any way he can. His art comes from his mother Matilde, a Puerto Rican woman who designs and sews, cooks and cleans, and makes the house look like a stylish magazine. But most important, she lies on the floor and draws with Jean-Michel on his father's old work papers. So Jean-Michel Basquiat was inspired by his creative mother in New York. From her, he learns that art is not only in the poetry books she reads to him or in the theaters and museums they visit. Art is the street games of little kids. In our style and the words that we speak, it's how the messy patchwork of the city creates new meaning for ordinary things. Everything is art. And art is everywhere around us. While visiting the museum, they look at his favorite works of art. Reading the story behind each artist, reading the story behind each work, this is how Jean-Michel learns what it means to be a famous artist. And do any of you recognize this work? I have it hanging in our classroom here. It's by a famous Spanish artist. He invented cubism. His name, Pablo Picasso. And this painting is La Guernica. And I've seen it, actually, myself. It is huge. It is awesome, and it inspired me just like it inspired Jean-Michel Basquiat. Back at home, he creates art on the floor as his father, Gerard, plays jazz records. Mama Matilde cooks arroz con pollo, rice and chicken, and calls Jean-Michel mi amor, which is Spanish for my love. The energy and life of the city can be felt in each line of his drawings. So music and culture influenced him so much. As time goes by, Jean-Michel learns that art has a healing power. After a car accident, he is scared and confused. Matilde gives him a book to calm his fears. It's filled with pictures of bones and skulls and the human body, and Jean-Michel draws it until he knows it all by heart. He's no longer afraid. So it's like a science book with all the different parts of the body, biology, anatomy. Back at home, Jean-Michel's body heals, but his heart breaks. His mother's mind is not well. The family breaks apart. She no longer lies on the floor and draws with Jean-Michel, but sits by the window singing only to the birds. Jean-Michel's confused. He's filled with the blues when Matilde can no longer live at home. She's being taken away and his heart breaks. There's a symbol of his heart there. He tries drawing the terrible out of his blues, but things are not the same. As Jean-Michel grows older, he visits his mother when he can, always bringing his artwork to show her, telling her that one day it will be in a museum when he's a famous artist. And actually, if you can see, he drew Spider-Man there. A teenager now, Jean-Michel decides, "Papa, I'm going to be very famous one day." And with a sly look and a twinkle in his eye, Jean-Michel leaves Brooklyn, for the Lower East Side of New York City, a concrete jungle where only the tough survive. During the day, dressed in a green jumpsuit splattered with paint, Jean-Michel stays with friends, sleeping on couches and floors, leaving a barrage of collages and poem-filled papers everywhere he goes. So collage, he likes to glue pieces together, cut and paste, add words and poetry that he writes, all sorts of things. At night, Jean-Michel spray paints the walls downtown with poems and drawings that catch the eye of artists, gallery goers, and passerby. Under his art, he signs the name Samu instead of Jean-Michel. Everybody wants to know who's Samu. So he's using a fake name. Samu moves from street corners to art gallery walls with powerful color composition and line, collaging and painting on anything he can find. His art is still not neat or clean, definitely not inside the lines, but it's still beautiful and interesting. With his magical charm, Jean-Michel draws a crowd, but when it's time to work, he prefers to be alone, with the radio and TV on full blast in the background. Now an expensive suit splattered with paint, he flips through stacks of magazines, open books, paints into the night, sometimes for days at a time, while sounds and images jump in his head. So he collages from newspapers, magazines, photographs, all sorts of drawings and paintings. He puts it all together to match his imagination. Jean-Michel, an artist among artists, never doubts one line, creating from a soundtrack that is all his own. People describe him as a radiant, wild, genius kid, but in his art, he is king, so he draws crowns for himself and others that he admires. So if he admires someone, he puts a crown over their head. A grown man now, with the art world in his hands, Jean-Michel Basquiat still visits his mother when he can. And at his most important shows, above all the critics, fans, and artists that he admires, the place of honor is his mother's, a queen on a throne. He's now a famous artist. And there's a picture in his artwork of him and his mother, and the crown is over his mom. And it says oro on top, which is Spanish for gold. So a golden crown for his queen mother. So, the story of Jean-Michel Basquiat. Never give up on your dreams. If you have sadness or tragedy in your life, you can overcome it. And you can still be whatever you want to be. And he wanted to be a famous artist. And it came true because he worked hard. He kept his positive attitude and champion spirit and never forgot who and what inspired him. So, until next time, mis amigos, adios.